good hope. My expectation is good. For my tomorrow, my expectation is good. My expectation about my friends is good. Do you know that every Sunday I believe all of you will come here by 5 p.m.? My expectation is good. Child expects good. It's in that child's eyes. Have you seen a child's eye? Have you seen a child's eye? Yeah. The eyes light up. There's expectation some good is coming. It's a terrible thing for children to be abused. Last year, 157 children died of sexual abuse. Died. Terrible thing. 5 children get sexually abused every day in Sri Lanka. It's terrible, isn't it? But thank God, our children lift up their eyes and they have expectation of good. They have not tasted evil. They have tasted and seen that the Lord is good. So we begin. We continue also by humbling. Matthew 18:4. Therefore, whoever shall humble himself like... Step number 2. Therefore, whoever shall humble himself like this little child, this one is the greater in the kingdom of heaven. We want to improve from where we are. And this word humble is not the humble we normally think. It's not something about our clothes. It's actually the Greek is the one who presses on himself like a little child. That is, a child puts all the child's weight on the parent who is carrying, isn't it? Child puts all the weight. Can we try this demonstration? Don't worry, I'm only 100 kilos. So imagine I am the child and this is my father. I just put, oh, you see. Thank you. That's the idea. All my weight. Humble means I just press all my cares, my burdens, my worries, my sins, everything not right with me, and everything that is right with me. The things that demean me and the things that exalt me, all that I put on him. Did you understand? That's the meaning. I just put all my weight, the good weight and the bad weight. I put it all on him. We all have a scale, isn't it? These are my plus points. My weight in gold is like this and my black side is like this. Everything goes on Jesus. So when you come to the cross, all the good and all the bad, he has taken over. So we can never say, this good part of me saved me. He saved me even from my goodness. Did you hear that? He saved me even from my goodness and exchanged his life with my life. So we press on to him. This is how we improve ourselves. We become trainable, teachable, love to learn. We learn new things. We are corrected easily because we are now a child. We don't allow bad habits. We train in good habits. We are dependent, humble, submissive as a child. And we have a wonder in our heart which is called worship. Will you say it with me? I have a wonder in my heart. Anytime my heart switches to worship, anytime my heart switches to worship, yes, I laugh easily, I am easily pleased. Are you? Are you? Child is easily pleased. Parent brings any child, easily pleased. We want to be childlike and not childish. All these characters can go wrong to the other side. But today we are talking about increasing childlikeness, increasingly Father providing, increasingly Father covering. This is greatness in the kingdom of God. Little unnerving at the beginning. It's like swimming. You want to put your feet on the water, but you can't swim and put the feet on the water. Don't I know this subject? You can't put your head down. You want to breathe inside the water, So it's a little like that. But as you allow Him to lead you, and all my worth is in Him. I have handed it all to Him. Increasingly He takes over, and increasingly He promotes me. Will you say God's way? God's way. God's way? God's way. 18:5. And whoever shall... So let's make this resolution for step number 2. Will you say with me, Father in heaven, increasingly, I just hand myself over to you. I am losing weight and gathering you. My own self-importance. Oh, what happened to it? It lost weight. And when we lose weight, God's glory increases in us. That is real weight. Thara bara. Proper weight. Otherwise, it's mostly the things we have accrued for ourselves. The content is less, the vessel is very heavy. But when God's glory comes, vessel thins out. It is called I decrease, He increase. John 3:30. I decrease, He increase. Will you say it with me? I decrease, He increase. So the vessel gets thinner and the contents get heavier. It's Christ in me, the hope of glory. Colossians 1:27. I am actually increasing real weight. My false weight falls on a put on things, those heavy Saul's armor. David was given Saul's armor and Saul's helmet and Saul's sword. Thank God he refused Saul's soul. He said, King, I'm used to my sling. So I'll have a fling at Goliath with the sling. So he did. So all that pottage goes off. Jesus increases. We don't have to be self-important, because the most important person in the universe is in me. Will you say in me? Christ in me. I don't have to gather importance. In fact, I let go importance. These all other paraphernalia of importance I have gathered, these vestments, garments, I let go. Jesus in me. Jesus. You know, I meet pastors all the time. They want to be called pastor. Otherwise, they'll take offense. I keep saying, please don't call me pastor. Uncle is very good enough. Is quite good enough. I really like it. It's in their title and it's in the manner they speak, you know. The ecclesiastical language when the prophecies come. We don't want any of that paraphernalia. Christ in me is enough. Will you please say, Christ in me is enough. I don't want other importance. Jesus in me increases. Jesus in me increases. Jesus in me increases. Step number 3. And whoever shall receive one such little child in my name receives me. These are very important, brothers and sisters. Our success story changes. What is success? Receiving one little child in Jesus' name into the Father's family. Now imagine the president coming through that door and I have to receive him. It's entirely possible. He can be saved. Because of his office, we will give due respect. Don't give any less when a child is being born into the family of the King of Kings. Get the point? Every child born into God's family, because of your witness, you are being appointed, assigned for the most holy, noble duty. What is that? Passing on Jesus' substance to someone, passing on Jesus' life. That child is born again. Today a lady came from Vanathamulla, ministered by Rohana and Sumudu. She looked so wasted. She was a pitiful example of a human being. They were living near a covil. Demons got into her. She got diabetes and demon possessed. She was lying on the floor, unable to get up. When Rohan and Sumudu went and prayed, she got up. And today she came for the service. So pitiful. She has to be nursed back literally to life. But it's a new birth. We received her as a princess came. And she fell down. And there was no pillow. We had to get some lady's handbag. I think it was. What are ladies' handbag brands? Armadillo or Giorgiano? I don't know these things. You know, George Armandi? Yeah. There was a nice handbag. I said, get that for the pillow. Nobody got that, but they got something for a pillow. She's a princess newly born into God's royal family. That she came from Manathamulla, didn't matter. She's so emaciated and wasted, didn't matter. She couldn't stand straight because demons are still going out of her. It didn't matter. We received her in Jesus' name into the best family possible, which is the Lord's family. Do you understand? Will you just stretch out your hands if you don't mind and say, Lord Jesus, I make this resolve. Let my hands receive in your name someone newly into your family. I consider my hands blessed by Jesus. Hands of Jesus, let my hands be. Thank you. Thank you. If you stand and do this, I'm sure you'll fall under the power of God. There's such a heavy presence of Jesus' gentleness around here. Step number 4, we are finishing quickly. Matthew 18:10. Take heed that you do not despise one of these little ones. Shall we make this resolution? Lord Jesus, every child of God, newly come into the family, any child of God, irrespective of their worldly position, I honor them. Will you please turn, maybe turn back, isn't it, and say, I honor you. Just here. I honor you. Yes. Simply because they are children of God, isn't it? So we will not depreciate. We will not take offense at them. They will have different ways, you know. I have my ways, you have your ways. But we are learning the ways of Jesus. We are learning the ways of Jesus. So Matthew 18:10, take heed that you do not despise one of these little ones. That's how Jesus thinks of huios, my own children. The Greek word here is my own little ones. Let you not despise my own little ones. If ever you think family of God is a messy place, absolutely it's full of people like you. And me, of course. Of course it's messy. It is messy. We are in a journey. We are in progress. We are becoming like Jesus. One day we make heaven. It has 12 foundations. Sapphire, topaz, ruby, emerald. What makes the new city Jerusalem? The qualities we are gathering. That makes new city Jerusalem. Qualities we are gathering. It's a nature of Jesus in us. There's, I go to prepare a place for you. In my Father's house are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you. When the place is ready, I come back. What is he preparing the place with? His substance in you is preparing a room for you. When that room is ready, he comes back personally to take you. You remember Stephen dying, stoned, vilified, publicly stoned, looked a pathetic death, isn't it? But did he see his pathetic death, or what did he see at that time? Lord Jesus Christ standing, hands open, coming down to receive him. So we don't know whether we will go before he comes a second time, or we will all wait till he comes a second time. We don't know. Whatever it is, there is a room God is preparing. With the God substance, you are cultivating. So let's do this. Lord Jesus, help me to cultivate the substance of Christ in my earthly journey. Every child of God, very precious. any little effort I can take to add substance to a child.